The restoration work on this statue itself has been carried out by Belting Studios of Peebles, and the stonework was cleaned and repointed by Sandy McLean Stonemason. As well as cleaning and repointing the inscriptions, which were showing signs of wear, have been painstakingly redefined by Hatton Stone. With all of this work taking place behind the covered working platform erected by HL Staffley, with additional support from Gordon Pringle. All of this work has been expertly organised by and managed by most of our past president, Grant Scott. This project was only made possible as a result of a huge fundraising effort by the club, with assistance from many others, and driven by past president Alan Bryden and committee man Jim Davidson, who I would now like to ask to say a few more words about the fundraising effort.
Thanks, Gary. Robert Marshall, Conrad Ritson, Mr. President, guests, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the ancient of the Most Troopers, it gives me great pleasure and immense pride to be here tonight for the unveiling of Hawick's most famous landmark. Instantly recognise the world over on TVs. I think it's fitting that the town's riding club deciding on the horse restoration as their contribution to the town's Prince and Community celebrations, and I hope everybody agrees that the work has been worth it. On behalf of the fundraising committee, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank the people who made this possible, and if I missed anybody, I apologise. Firstly, the club committee and public who turned up at the mayor for the past 3 years and Sundays after the come riding for the cleanup. It's hard work, but very rewarding. Past presidents, Lindsay Nicol, Scott Landy, Frank Scott, for staff in the bar at Must Fall for the club when the hotel was vacant. And thanks also to Frank for his assistance with the organising of the works and planning approvals. Probably our biggest fundraising activity, the Three Peaks Challenge, sponsored walk. And good luck to Team Theory Bus and their attempt to share. We didn't get the best of weather for it. I was going to say a bit like tonight after this morning, but actually it was a lot worse than the night. But I know everybody involved had a once in a lifetime experience, mostly because we never want to do it again. Well done to the team of Richard Walker, Gavin Gibbon, Nick Short, George Young, Robin Short, Scott Telford, John Lyle, Billy Davidson, ex-president Graham Nicol, and especially the support of Rory and David Calton, Ian Hyper, Scott, and Peter Marchbanks. One person I've not included yet, and unfortunately due to business commitments in Brussels, is unable to attend tonight, is another ex-president. I'd like to give a special mention to Alan Bryden. He was involved in everything and made a huge contribution to the fundraising effort. Not only did he sponsor one of the buses and take part in the walk, but along with his Scotia pals, kicked off our fundraising with a concert in the town hall. He then devoted a huge amount of his time to putting together the Most Troopers Club CD, which launched last year, and if you've heard it, I'm sure you'll agree it's quiche. If you've not heard it, stock copies available. Carl, I hope you'll pass on our thanks. Of course, the CDE would not have been possible without performers. So thanks to everybody who gave up their time and their talent to make a contribution. And I think special thanks to Big Sharp, who made his last recording. Unforgettable. Thanks to Bentley Studios, Hutton Stone, Sun and the Queen Stonemasons for their hard work, care and attention while seeing the restoration. And also William Lucky's for the help of recovery. Finally, I'd like to thank the Hawick public for their great support and generosity without which the restoration would not have taken place. Many thanks again, I hope you like the results.
Thanks very much, Jim. I'd now like to ask
one at Christmas and his last header.
Robert Marshall, Desiree Kyle, fellow members of the Most Troopers Club, ladies, gentlemen, boys and girls. Firstly, I'd like to thank the Most Troopers Club for the kind invite here tonight to perform the unveiling of the restored 1514 memorial. My lads, Ella and myself, are truly honoured to be given this very special role. It makes this occasion even more special because of the fact that it's 100 years since the erection of the horse and the first unveiling in 1914, and it is also the 500th anniversary year of our flag being brought back from Horns Hole. It really is hard to put into words how privileged we are. It's also great to see so many Hawick folk here tonight to witness this historic occasion. I'm sure you will all be overwhelmed with the finished result. Once again, thank you to the Most Troopers Club for this great honour. We'll cherish this night for the rest of our lives. Provost Marshall, President Kyle, fellow members of the Most Troopers Club, ladies, gentlemen, boys and girls, thank you.
That brings quaint thoughts as it wambles through. It flows fair long syne and wambles along, keeps it running hour and all board a song. The breeze that it lapped seemed like lint in old gold. By ages of cunt, the times that are rolled. And year after year, as the June days draw nigh, a horseman stands gale with flood through the sky. Bower and the horseman in yesterday line, wardens of customs come to for long syne. Bower and a horseman, yes, yen every year, uplifting the slogan, a teary as dear. The stream has to us a cheer more chain. It minds us affecting days that are gained. For every summer, it cries out with pride, where is my cornet? Get mounted and ride. Say fair, fair, but the long road it has come. A cornet has been without gold or drum. The talents are high, revere and acclaim. The heroes have got their banner of fame. Bower and the riding men, steadfast and true, rearing on high the banner of blue. Each proudly waving his flag in the air. Four hundred cornets, Bower and Mayor.
Thank you, everybody.